Our third candidate is somebody who had an important role to play when the budget repair bill was being held up in court. And I'd like you to welcome a man who served as our Secretary of State for a large number of years and is now also running for the governor for the state of Wisconsin to challenge Scott Walker. Please welcome Doug LaFollette.
Good afternoon. I want to thank you all for inviting me to come. Wisconsin has been under attack for the last year by Mr. Walker, Fitzgerald Boys, and Koch Brothers Money, and the wild Alex White Ring ideas from Arizona or wherever they bring them from. You know, it's quite apparent to me after years of living in Wisconsin and traveling in Wisconsin and working with you for you folks that they don't respect our values and our progressive traditions. They rejected the concept that government is something that is good for people and provides services for people. What they've done is to get that, and they've given tax breaks to corporations and paid for them by cutting money for public schools, cutting money for our technical schools, taking money away from university research. They've attacked workers' rights, and now they've got a major attack on women's rights. They've raised taxes on the poor, and they've taken thousands of people off bedroom care. You know, what more can you do to insult the people of Wisconsin? You know, I've always believed that government has a role to play in society. When I was a very small child, my father worked for WPA, and that was my first experience with the government. He got out of college, he worked for the WPA, and that's the kind of program that as governor I would think would be good for Wisconsin, because we have people who need work, and we have work that needs to be done. And then in college, I had what I call a union scholarship. I had what I called a union scholarship. I had a job, I was a union member, and I got paid enough because of that I could pay my tuition. I think it was about $1.51 an hour at that time. Anyway, after thinking about this for a long time, I decided I could not stand idly by and let everything we hold dear be torn down. Now more than ever, we need to join together in a fight to return Wisconsin to her progressive traditions. My campaign will be about restoring civility to our state, about renewing the Wisconsin idea that utilizes local talent to find solutions to our problems. You know, in this election, 46% of people are going to vote for Walker, and 46% are going to vote for the Democrat candidate, no matter who that's going to be. So it's that 8% in the middle that's going to decide who the next governor is. And I have strong statewide reputation. I've traveled the state for many years, and I've campaigned, and people respect me, and I also get votes from independent Republicans and progressives as well as just Democrats. You know, my recognition is what's going to make this a possible campaign to defeat Walker. I'm not seen as a Madison liberal or a big city mayor. I'm seen as a very independent candidate who can attract votes from people all across the spectrum. As you may remember, when Tommy Thompson got elected four straight times, I got elected those same four times, and fortunately, when we got Mr. Walker and lost our dear Senator Feingold, I was able to get reelected as well. So with your help, we can send Mr. Walker back to the private sector, where with a slight smile, he may be able enough to satisfy his wife. Special interest money has corrupted our democracy. Super PAC, out-of-state money, millions of dollars coming in, attack ads on television have already started. Nothing can be more tragic than to see what's happened with the millions of dollars that have been coming from out-of-state. The people of Wisconsin deserve a governor who will listen to them. And I will take no money from these special interests, even ones I agree with. And I will not run any attack ads on TV. You know, I'll only be beholden to the people of Wisconsin who elect me. My campaign will not be about big money, attacks by TV. I call it a better way. And please, look at my website, doublefollow.com, and I explain how the better way can work. I run this way not because it's easy, but because it's the right way. I'm not running just against Scott Walker, but I'm running for the people of Wisconsin. The patriotic Wisconsinites, many of whom are here, who stood in the cold and stood in the rain and gathered millions of signatures to say that we want to do it a different way here in Wisconsin. And Doug LaFollette calls that a better way, and I would appreciate your support. Thank you very much.